Hello everyone. In today's episode, our main concern is to make enough money to repay at least a portion of our current loan of 600,000 rubles. To achieve this, I recorded the entirety of 1963, and will fast forward through it in 3x speed. I forgot to film any montage footage, so it's all going to be pure gameplay, except for the usual intro and outro that we are used to. Well, let's get to it. After finishing this recording, the raw video file came out at a whopping 2.5 hours long. So, here's the deal. I will keep the editing to a minimum. I will keep a constant 3x speed. What little happens this year, I think I can commentate without needing to slow down the footage, so I doubt I will ever interrupt the time lapse. We will fast forward through the entirety of 1963, and end the video at the very start of 1964. Despite this episode being mostly about repaying loans, I just couldn't help myself, and did manage to squeeze in a couple smaller construction projects. Most of the time I dealt with small improvements, but I'll explain as we get to them. Take this warehouse for example. As you might have noticed, I replaced that farm field before placing it. Its entrance was facing east, and since we cannot trim that side down, I just flipped it around. This way we can place the warehouse, and it will simply cut off parts of the field it occupies. It is essential that we build a warehouse, since we have to store the food somewhere before it gets picked up. Plus it acts as a convenient train station, for which we just barely managed to squeeze in some tracks. As you may remember, our town substation is close to its limit, so it is advisable that we start planning for the future. I will replace the central substation with 2 new ones that will be positioned at the edge of town. I will spend more time on arranging the power cables later. This is just a rough draft, basically. For now, I will just make sure that both of the new substations can cover the whole town. Eventually, I want to move away from using power poles and start using underground cables. Way cleaner aesthetically, and the only drawback is a couple more substations dotted around town, and maybe more than one transformers at the edge of town. But that is for when we build our first power station. For now, we just have to grit our teeth and learn to live with a couple high-capacity power lines running along our roads. Underground cables have lower throughput, but they don't result in this kind of a jumbled mess of wires. At first I wanted to only use a single tractor and harvester for the first year, to judge how well they would cope, but I decided to just buy more and not waste a whole year for that experiment. The main structure is finished. We just have to build the roof, and the food factory is complete. Maybe it's not a good idea to cover the messages with info windows. We had a fire while I wasn't paying attention. There. No more materials required. It's smooth sailing from here. Yeah, just checking if I could fit the warehouse. But would have been a bad place anyways. We kind of need that factory connection to be efficient. Despite the snow, the road works are progressing at a decent pace. Since we have two gravel storages at this point, we might as well assign the second construction office to the one in the industrial sector. And food production is ready to go. Once we have the first harvest in the silos, we can start busing workers out here. In order to take advantage of the factory connection, we need to redesign the road layout a little bit around here. There we go. Of course I should have planned for having that warehouse in the first place, but I think this is an acceptable workaround. Since the infrastructure around the food factory will be busier than the roads leading to the farm fields, it is all set to be upgraded to gravel. Despite having a small spike in unemployment in the last episode, we are back to having pretty much everyone working. Maybe we can afford a third apartment block. And since we're here, let's upgrade one of the entrances for each houses now. They can use the other one in the meantime. Doing this cosmonaut playthrough made me appreciate the actual value of different kinds of infrastructure. Being forced to start with low-cost roads, and work our way up to more efficient ones, is kind of eye-opening. And the fact that it takes months to build projects that would take a couple days at most with quick building, is also way more interesting. It forces me to plan the actual layout more carefully, not committing to anything if I am not 110% sure that it will stand the test of time. Plus, remember that warehouse we had to squeeze in earlier? Knowing that demolishing something would erase months of hard work, makes it so much more satisfying when I find a way to work around a problem like that. Yay! Spring is here. not much longer before we start planting crops for the first time. With one side of the entrance complete, we can build the other one. I'm starting to think that these high-capacity dumpers are not really the best choice for constructions. Most of the time they are called to deliver gravel to construction sites, and usually that's around 10 to 20 tons. We can speed things up if we replace them with a smaller, but faster model. Luckily, we have just the thing. This other one is twice as fast, with half the cargo space. Even on gravel roads that only allows a 60 km per hour speed, it should be a better choice. And would you look at that? Our autonomous farming drones are hard at work. Who knew Soviet engineers mastered driverless technology in the 1960s? Next on the agenda, upgrading these small vestiges of dirt roads around the Republic. We have too many of them spread all over the place. They are small enough that they don't cause too much of a disruption, but I just really want to get rid of them. And we can finally do what this episode is all about, repay the first 100,000 rubles of our loans. The more we repay, the less of an impact it will have on our profits. I think we can replace the dumpers from the distribution office too. I'll just wait for them to finish their current tasks, and I'll sell them when they are empty. Okay, the construction yard's driveway is finished. Let's do the gravel storage now. Only the second CO will be able to deal with it, since that's the one that has the new gravel storage assigned, but that's okay. It's closer to it. So it will be able to deliver the resources faster. Plus, I deleted the roads in front of the apartment blocks. They were really unnecessary. Okay then. The old lumbering dumpers are out, and the faster ones are in. Let's see how they cope with their workloads. The old truck would still be moving towards the pickup point right now. I'm starting to think replacing them was a good idea. With the cold days of winter behind us, we can now safely sever the power connection to the town since we don't need the heat exchangers to work. Time to hook up the new substations. You'll see me designating small pieces of dirt roads to be upgraded. I try to do this when I know that dumpers are free, so they can deal with it as soon as possible. But just in case, I added that footpath for the clinic, so people can still walk in if they can. And with the Old Town power connection no longer being necessary, I'll delete it now. Of course, I failed to realize that with this move I severed the industrial power supply too. Good thing we have the transformer ready to go, so it won't take much to reconnect it to the network. There we go, the power distribution for the town is upgraded. I will break the rules of the cosmonaut challenge here for a little bit. I was not happy with how the old substation was positioned. I built a new one at the other side of the bus stop, so the power inlet is facing the right way. Unfortunately, by demolishing the old, before connecting the new, I cut power to the asphalt and concrete plants. I had no choice but to quick build some small parts of this project. This is where I realized that I cut power to the industrial district. But as I said, we had the transformer on standby. Lucky us. I was wondering why the cement mixer trucks kept going back and forth, never picking up anything at the concrete factory. Well, I already told you why. Here, I carefully quick built the part that required concrete, and immediately switched back to manual building. The last phase will also require concrete, so I'll have to quick build that part too. Also, that bus ran out fuel at exactly the worst possible spot. Instead of selling it and rebuying it, I just quick built this power line too. It already had all of the materials delivered, so we paid for 11 days of foreign labor. Please forgive me. Now to upgrade the distribution office's driveway. We have to be fast with this one. Most things can go without deliveries for a little bit, but the town store is more sensitive to these kinds of outages. And since we are at it, let's do the piece at the customs house too. I'll specifically assign the closest CO to it, so gravel will be delivered ASAP. Unfortunately, it's a very short segment, so we will have to wait for the bus to go into town to pick up workers. We ran out of meat, but I think bread will be fine. With that, things are moving again, and the border outpost is fully upgraded at last. Once I'm happy with the level of stocks in the store, I'll deal with its driveway too. Since we are getting rid of these old dirt connections, I'll quickly upgrade the original clothing chains roads too. There. It was more for the sake of aesthetics, since dirt roads work just fine. This just looks more consistent. Speaking of looking consistent, let's quickly do something about these asphalt paths that lead to nowhere. This switch is no longer useful. Thanks for all your hard work, but you're obsolete. Blink and you'll miss it. I unpaused the apartment block as we drove by. While editing this part, I just realized that I should reassign both CO buses to the town depot. Having both right next to the bus station would speed things up considerably. I was really not happy with how this junction looked. At first I was trying to connect the distribution office up to it, but it make it look worse. In the end I gave up, demolished the whole thing and rebuilt it. They can use a dirt service road for a while. There. I really didn't like that sudden sharp angle. The new layout should be more pleasing to look at. The third prefab panel block is done. That looks better, doesn't it? And now we can remove the last vestiges of the old power delivery network. We can cover up the path it carved for itself with some trees, and it's like it was never there. You might be asking, why is he building a service connection along the main highway? I think you know. Because the asphalt plant is supplied with gravel from the other side of the current Republic, it's going to take a little while to finish. In hindsight, I should have just allowed the local distribution office to pick up gravel from the original storage too, but we are not in a hurry this episode, so it's fine. It's just not the most riveting viewing experience. And since it's the middle of summer, we can look forward to some superfluous messages telling us the heating plant stopped working. Thanks to the distances involved, it's gonna take a while to build this new asphalt road. We are so close. There. The asphalt has been laid on top, now we just need the roller to go through it a couple times, and we will have the very first proper piece of paved road in the country. Again, I can only imagine the amount of research that went into developing these driverless vehicles that are capable of doing construction work. I'm kidding, of course. I just hope the developers will put some kind of random citizen model in the driving seat when the vehicle is moving. And since we are on a roll, why stop here? We only have to make sure we don't block access to important buildings. Here I notice that our money reached the next 100,000 ruble milestone, so let's repay the next installment of our loans. We started this episode with 600,000 in debt. Now we are down to 400,000. We won't repay everything before the end of the year, just so you don't get your hopes up. Here, I reassigned two dumpers to the industrial distribution house, and also moved the gravel supply job to that office. It makes more sense to have that building handle it, since it's much closer to the source, so less time spent running empty. We just need to wait for the trucks to arrive at their new home, and aggregate goods will become available in the list of things the office can handle. There. I just have to keep supplying bitumen and cement from the border, and gravel from the industrial district. I will have to make a second pass at this distribution setup. At a quick glance it will work, but I think I can still make it run better. And we have the first harvest waiting in the silos, ready to be baked into bread. We can start ferrying workers to the food factory. And we definitely want to unpause the warehouse construction, so we can store the food we are about to make. I was trying to see if any of the other trucks would be a better choice for moving crops from the fields to the silos, but due to the speed restrictions posed by dirt and gravel roads, the current stable of trucks is the best we can have right now. And here I was double, and then triple checking that all the fields are assigned properly. It seems four tractors will be able to sow every field, and maybe 10 harvesters can cut everything before the winter cold destroys the crops. We will definitely need one more small distribution office to deal with the amount of deliveries, but that's about all we need to have this setup work at 100%. And the food warehouse is complete. I think we just managed to make our food situation completely self-sufficient. I'll just let it run for a little bit, and then set up a food delivery line later. Isn't that blue graph just amazing? And to think we had about 50 citizens with university degrees at the start. We came a long way, and we only had two, quote unquote, escapes since we started. Not bad. Not bad at all. Let's quickly check how the power network is doing. Everything's green. That's reassuring. And the heating networks seem to be working fine too. I was trying desperately to find a way to free the rail connection. I guess we can still move the vehicle depot if we had to, so it's not a lost cause. Time to start moving our fresh food to our people. I'll do the usual setup. Pick up at the factory, make a drop off at the store, and sell the rest at the border. I'll just lower the amount bought by the distribution house, so we only resort to foreign imports if production stops at the farm for some reason. But with the amount we store in those two silos, we should have enough for a year. Also, let's not forget to rename the two new transport routes, so we know what's what. This new tractor looks like a way better option than the old model. And it's not really that more expensive, so we can safely replace the current stable. At this point I started to flirt with the idea of maybe doing oil next. Our finances are at a level where I may be able to afford either a gas power plant or go straight for a refinery. I would need to import crude oil at first, but as you can see, I'm already scouting for potential oil fields I can exploit. For me, a power station would be a good place to start. We can import oil for a while, but I would prefer to have a well-established presence on the international oil market before I start thinking about building refineries. Plus, I already have a ready-made place for it. I can build it in the industrial district, and it can power all of it by itself, and we already have a high-voltage switch there that goes to the border, so we can sell excess electricity, and to the town, so we can power that too. We are still buying food. The turnover of the food delivery line is just too slow. Setting the distribution office to ship food when it falls below 50% should be okay. By the way, I accidentally set the food line to buy food at the border. That may have been a contributing factor too. But it's all fixed now. In preparation for the eventual upgrading of the roads leading into the bus stop, I'll just place a temporary footpath, so workers can still walk to every workplace at the border outpost. Now that's what I like to see. Food imports drop to zero, and people are still being fed. We can still buy it if things get desperate, but we should be able to feed our people with only homegrown food. Farming season is over. The new tractors should be able to sow every field quite quickly next year. They're supposed to be much faster than the old ones, and we have 10 harvesters, so that part won't be a problem either. We just have to see if the single distribution house can deal with the current number of fields. Most of them are not full-sized, so we might be good on that part. We are 20 days until New Year. I think we did okay. Here, I'm just trying to see what kind of parking would best fit into these spots. I'm not sure I want to give personal vehicles to our citizens, the traffic would be horrible, but I'm still curious. Well, we did manage to pay back 200,000 rubles from our loan, and if we had just a couple more days, I think two more rounds of exports would have been enough to repay another 100,000. All in all, I'd say this was a good relaxing year. I'm more and more convinced that building an oil power plant should be the topic of the next episode. With that, we could eliminate power imports, and make some extra money by selling electricity back at the border. And I did notice that the loyalty of our people is starting to slip quite a bit. A couple more monuments should boost us back to the 30% range. It's a real shame the statues have such low range. I'd love to have one of them in a prominent place. And we are out of time. It is now 1964. Time for a cut. Despite starting this year as a purely money-making venture, we did end up making some progress. All of the busy pieces of dirt roads were upgraded, the food industry is up and running, and we even managed to squeeze in a bit of road paving, so the main highway between the border and the town is now made of asphalt. Sure, we only managed to fully repay 200,000 rubles, but the fact that we made progress on that front is encouraging. Building a power plant in the next episode might be tricky. They are very big projects and our construction infrastructure may not be up to the task. But if we only manage to get started, that's still something. I hope you liked the video. If you did, dropping a like and subscribing to the channel just might motivate me to make more. Until then, see you later.